Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM AppConnect Enterprise team. In this video, I will demonstrate how to configure administration security in AppConnect Enterprise version 11 so that you must enter a user ID and password to perform administrative actions from the toolkits or web UI. I will be demonstrating this using an integration node, but the same configuration can also be applied for an independent integration server. I'm using Linux, so I'll run MQSI profile to set up the environment. I will create and start a brand new integration node using MQSI create broker. By typing MQSI list, I can see the administration URI for the integration node. When I enter it in the browser, I can access the administrative web UI for the node. I can perform an administrative task like creating an integration server. Similarly, I can connect to the integration node from the toolkit and see the integration server that I just created. The integration node can be configured using a configuration file called node.conf.yaml. The file is created when the integration node is first created. To access the file, cd to $MQSI registry. You will see a number of system directories used by ACE. Now, cd components. You'll see a directory which has the same name as your integration node. Now cd into that directory. In this directory, you'll see the file called node.conf.yaml and an overrides directory. Edit the file node.conf.yaml. You will see a number of configuration options for the integration node. To enable admin security so that a user ID and password is required, I will uncomment the line for basic auth. This instructs ACE to use basic auth to authenticate the user ID and password for a user before allowing the user to perform administrative tasks. I'll save and close the file. I can create a user ID and password for a user by using the command MQSI web user admin. I'm specifying the user ID to be admin. I'm specifying the password to be password. The dash C flag indicates to create the new user ID. I now need to stop and start the integration node. If I now refresh the web UI page, I see that I am required to enter a user ID and password. If I enter the wrong password, I am not allowed to proceed. After entering the correct user ID and password, I can access the administrative web UI. Similarly, if I refresh the integration node in the toolkit, I am informed that I am unauthorized to access the integration node. I can click on Modify Connection on the integration node and enter the user ID and password. I can optionally save the password in the Eclipse Credential Vault so that I don't need to supply the password if I restart the toolkit. After entering the correct user ID and password, I can access the integration node from the toolkit. In this video, I've shown how to configure administration security in IBM AppConnect Enterprise version 11 so that a user ID and password is required to perform administrative tasks.